Welcome to this presentation on Microsoft Word headings. My name is Greg Kraus, University IT Accessibility Coordinator at NC State University. So why are headings important? First, they help screen reader users easily navigate the page by being able to jump from heading to heading as opposed to having to read the entire page at once to find out where your major sections are of your page. Second, it's a requirement of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines 2.0. In this demonstration, I'm going to show you the steps to properly use headings in your Microsoft Word documents. The first thing to note is you need to use Microsoft Word's built-in styles to denote your headings within your page. This is opposed to simply changing the font for different parts of your text to show how the text is broken up. After you've used Microsoft Word's built-in styles, the last step is to make sure you create your document as a tagged PDF. A tagged PDF puts in the extra coding necessary to allow assistive technologies such as screen readers the ability to use those headings to their advantage. This is a sample Microsoft Word document that doesn't have any styling added to it yet. There are different sections to this page, so how should I go about adding in my headings? The temptation is to come in and to select the text and then come over here and potentially change the size. Then here I have a heading. So I'll make that maybe slightly smaller. And I've got another heading. So I'll make that slightly smaller too. The problem is, if that's how I put in my headings, there's no meaning to those. It's just a visual change of the text. What I need to do is actually denote that that top line is an actual heading for the page, and the next line with the ICT accessibility regulation, that's a heading, a section of my page, and then the accessibility training is another section. So I'm going to undo those changes. Now here's how I should do it. I'll take my first heading here, and using the style menu, I'll just choose heading 1. And then for the next most important point, I'll make that a heading 2. And then I've got another point here, which is of the same importance, so I'll make that a heading 2. And I'll scroll down, and I'll just continue to do that for all of my headings. When I do this, I gain a couple of other advantages. So here you say, well, maybe I don't want this text to be underlined like that. I want to change the style of it. So instead of coming over here and selecting the text and now choosing to not underline it, what I'm going to do is in my style menu is I'm going to right click and I'm going to choose to modify the heading 2 style. When I do that, I can define what the heading 2 looks like. So if I don't want it underlined, I can do that. Click OK. And now every place I had a heading 2 has changed to match that style. So using the built-in styles helps me keep a consistent look and feel to my page without having to remember every place I need to go change a particular style. If you're done editing your document and you save this as a Microsoft Word file, if you share this with anybody, even if they do use a screen reader, the heading information is already stored in there. But if you want to turn this into a PDF file, there's one extra step you need to do. So I'll come to the File menu. And I have a save as Adobe PDF. Now different versions of Word will have this in slightly different locations, but I always want to look at my options to make sure I have the correct options checked. And here I have enable accessibility and reflow with tagged Adobe PDF, and I want to make sure that's checked. And almost always that is checked by default, but it's good to double check. I'll choose OK, and just save. And now you have a PDF document that has all the accessibility features needed for assistive technology users.